really fine performer, and you have the quality of knowing that music always means something. You know, you don't want 1 second go by so that you don't say something. Now that's a moment to start to doubt sometimes, do I say the right thing? Is that like this? Or maybe I'm just wanting to fill a void. For example, how is that Haydn sonata? Is that second movement that romantic or not? And when I say romantic, I don't mean the quantity of expression. Because I think that music is romantic as such. I think that Palestrina is romantic too. But music started to say something when it started to be. But what did it say, how it said it? That was different in different times. And can you look at it with Haydn's eyes or Haydn's contemporary's eyes or yours only or a mixture of the two? I think that some turns in the second movement are too obviously romantic. It doesn't have to be less, but somehow more contained in form. You know, we can express practically the same thing in many different ways. What can we use as means of expression? If I want to be very rational about it, I say that, you know, you play the notes sooner or later and louder and softer, and practically that's all we can do. And with those two relationships, we can create a world. Now, if you are very free in time, then maybe you think about another period of music making. You know, time became somehow looser later. In Haydn's time, it depends on which instrument you think. There were instruments, they had no dynamic possibilities. There were some, they had great sensitivity. It is an intimate instrument. Then what kind of emotions? Sometimes you speak music in first person. See, I. You know, when you play a Chopin nocturne, then you speak I. In some older music, music is somehow in quotation mark. I cannot say that in any scientific or musicological way. You know, just I'm speaking as it comes to my mind. For example, if I think about love expressed in music, then there is Tamino and Tamina. And Mozart probably expected us to identify with them. When I hear Tamino singing, I am Tamino. Now there is the other couple, Papageno and Papagena. When I hear Papageno singing, I don't feel like being Papageno. So that is in quotation mark, one step removed. It's an illustration of something. Something that they call in America puppy love. When you don't resonate, when you don't identify, but understand. The way when the child is afraid in the night, then you understand, you sympathize, but you are not afraid. So you don't share the feeling. And when you look at Tamino and Tamino in love, you think about your own love. But Papageno and Papageno, you are watching from the outside. So those are the two attitudes. Now, I think that this Haydn sonata should be played from the outside. And you play it from the inside. I said that I cannot make musicological sense and even psychologically not much. But I feel what I'm talking about. Now, if you have the right antennas, then maybe you do too. That's a different emotional world than if you play. That's me. You know, I resonate all the way, so to speak. But here, no, I feel that I'm exaggerating. I'm not really very sincere. I just don't want to look indifferent, so I do something. So start the slow movement a little bit. This bar, I mean this phrase, and then to play this phrase. Now, can you play the second time so that it moves much more?
Mm-hmm.
Because if you play it the way you play it, it sounds like first time all those notes were missing. And then you fill in the gaps. Mm-hmm. No, that... ornament it more. Yeah. There is more real thing happening. So you don't have to invent anything. It's really happening.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, play the second one. Yes, and then you remember. And that's a real big happening. You don't have to do anything about it. So instead of dressing it up, get to the real body of the thing. And then somehow what you are going to do will be simpler, but more truthful.
Mm-hmm.
What you did was very beautiful. And this kind of approach, what I'm doing now, is only if I really admire something that is happening. I don't talk about anything secondary. I try to talk about the essence as much as one can talk about the essence. Now, we could go through the whole movement like that, finding real things.
Mm.
You want to say something?
No.
No?
No.
So how does it go on from the- From here, play the right hand and I will play the left hand, okay?
Okay.
Yes. Now, if you could do that alone, you know what the difference was?
Mm.
Okay, then play the two. two hands. One step.